When it comes to mealtime, many parents struggle to get their kids to make healthier choices. But did you know that having a better understanding of taste bud development can actually help make that battle easier? Today, I'm getting some insight from an expert on how to work with your child to maximize nutrition at mealtime. So here to explain it all is registered dietitian Patty Milligan. And Patty, you specialize in the neuroscience of taste. What does that mean exactly?
Basically, it's the study of taste buds / saliva and understanding how it registers in the brain. And ultimately, the end result of this is to see why people like what they like. And if we're going to move kids toward healthier eating, could we understand taste bud development? And if we were patient with those taste buds and introducing different types of foods, could we grow up those taste buds and get a very well-rounded profile eater?
You say saliva is a big part of that. How does saliva play a role in our taste bud development?
Saliva is important not only to help begin the digestion of food, right? But also the quantity and the quality of it actually nourishes taste buds. And what we know is the way that they grow and mature and regenerate is based on the saliva. So it becomes really important that we do what we can to make sure that child has adequate saliva and that they are eating in a very calm environment, because that produces a better saliva.
For this taste bud development, explain what that development spectrum is.
Typically, it's three pockets on the spectrum. It all is related to their concentration in your mouth. So I like to akin it to communities. So if we talk about a very concentrated amount of taste buds, that would be like living downtown Chicago. That would be living in a condo. In other words, all of those taste buds are very present and they're very crowded together. The largest bulk of kids, and it's about 55%, are ones that probably live in suburbia as far as concentration of taste buds. So in other words, they have evenly spaced taste buds of all five, so they're able to have that kind of communication in a very controlled manner. And then the most sparse, I like to akin it to a farming community. It's a child that has such few taste buds, they're spread out like farms, and in that case, the maturity of those taste buds is going to take a little bit more tender care to find the bitter and the salty and the umami flavors, because sweet is the strongest and the most mature that we pop out as a baby.
Patty, how do parents figure out where their kids fall on this taste bud development spectrum?
There's a quick and dirty test you can do at home with your child. It's basically take a saltine cracker. And so you're gonna have a stopwatch and you're gonna ask them to chew the cracker and tell you when they taste the sweet. We have kids that can taste a sweet within 5 to 10 seconds. And we have others that don't taste that sweet to 40 seconds to a minute.
You have some advice for parents. Let's start with the first part of it, and that would be kids that are picky eaters.
So we wanna choose foods that are kind of subliminal in their tastes. In other words, ones that tend to be a little sweeter. So first and foremost, the sweet taste buds can pick it up. Some of the best veggies are to try to choose veggies that have a sweet bent. The sweet beets, the sweet potatoes, pick them up. You can also do sweet peas.
So let's move on to kids that have a sweet tooth. What is your advice for parents for those kids?
When we say they have a sweet tooth, their spacing of their taste buds are likely very spread out and their sweet is predominant. We want to honor that while at the same time growing up and nurturing the development of the other taste buds. So the best way to do it is to choose veggies and then a dipping sauce. When it has the dipping sauce, once it gets to the sweet, it sends a signal to the brain, go, oh, this food is safe, it's okay. And over time then, the taste buds have the luxury of picking up the other tastes. So you could choose something like a maple syrup or a little honey, a little bit of a sweet mustard.
And finally, Patty, let's talk about distracted eating. How do parents manage that?
Researchers say about 55% of the kids they have a taste bud development much like suburbia, right? So they have good paced taste buds. But the biggest issue for them for healthy eating is distraction. So one of the best ways we can help them is change up what's on the plate. And what I mean by that is do some visual stimulation and then also change textures. You might put those veggies in a ramekin where they stand up, and that slows down the meal and allows their focus to come front and center for the food.
Great information, Patty. Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, it was my pleasure. And happy eating, and treat your taste buds to a good meal.
If you want more healthy eating advice for the entire family, just head to our website, livinghealthytv.com. So if you like this video and want more Living Healthy, just subscribe to our channel.